And welcome back, everyone. Mika-san here with more ReCore. This game just started out, and it's not that much impressing me, at least in gameplay-wise. And now that I look at it, the graphics aren't anything really to talk about either. I do like the dog, the robot dog. But let's move on. Exit the crawler. As other people, you know, won't be. Okay, also people, it's nighttime. At least the evening's settling in, so the coquitos are chirping, so please try to ignore those damn little frog things. Whatever. Grand steps. Jesus Christ, that thing does have long loading screens. Well, didn't I get the update?
The pylon is in the next sector, Mac. Let's get going.
Okay. I need to try to upgrade the gun. Worn out. Okay, more parts. And this here looks. What is this? Nope. See the map here. Before I continue, I really want to see these locations here. What is that over there? Huh? Well, where? What? Okay, I'll go up there. I can't go up there now, huh? Oh, that thing! Whoa! What the fuck? God damn it. Alright, there's something. What is that over there? Oh, might as well see. Mac, can you find anything? If I can apparently if I can upgrade his head unit all the way to max, you'll be able to do this automatically, which would be a massive time saver.
Mac, Dig in.
Anything, boy? Can I go? I'm hoping I can. No, I can't. Yeah, it's like, I shouldn't bother, really. I should just wait until I find more of the robot parts. And do it in my free time.
There's the crawler gate. I'll have to initiate the manual override since our hunk of junk is buried in the sand.
Okay, that's dangerous. I thought we could just, like, use it to jump over or something like that, but nope. The hunk of junk out of the crawler.
And we're in.
That was simple enough. Oh, man. Angela is stunned. Okay. The higher the quality of the enemy, the more fusion energy it yields if extracted. Alright. Enemy to blow. Okay. You know, I'm gonna have to cut. Yeah, I should just edit these damn loading screens up.
This planet with an Earth-like atmosphere. It wasn't perfect, but it sure had potential.
Yeah, maybe after some massive terraforming. But hell, yeah, I mean, people make a living.
You got the scent, Mac?
You got anything, boy? There's something. Well, there's something right there. Looks like, Oh, I want to see one of those audio logs.
Good morning, Dr. Roldan. How are you feeling? This is Communications Director Natalie Bright, Houston Mission Control.
Houston.
Unfortunately, this is an unscheduled transmission. I'm sure you can see that you have not reached Far Eden. In fact, you're still technically inside the Sol system. But we noticed some discrepancies in one of the engine status reports and wanted to make sure it was nothing serious. As you know, any errors in reports prepared by Corbot crew members need to be addressed by the mission commander, which, in this case, is you. Sorry to have interrupted your sleep with an emergency alarm, but I must insist you send me an updated status report within 12 hours ship time. I'll be overseeing all Far Eden mission comms as we work through this issue. I hope we can start things off on the right foot.
Huh. Excuse me, I'm sorry, people. Need a cough. So, yeah.
Stay alert, Mac. The core bots in this sector look corrupted, too.
So, they don't have... I'm getting they don't have FTL. Okay, well, there are more bad guys. Did not know that. So these guys don't apparently have FTL, I'm guessing. Good boy! Nice! I love this dog. Worn lens. Well, windstorm. You think you put on your goggles, right?
Pylon. It's totally grounded. To the pylon before that storm hits.
What storm? Is there a storm? I couldn't see. I mean, I could tell it's coming, but I didn't see any. I really wish I could understand Mac.
That structure is the pylon's control center. Or what's left of it, anyway.
Whoa, crap! Come on, let's move. There we go. Okay, stabilizer and pad, perfect. Might be able to make more parts for K9. You know, I know K9 is a very common name for a robot dog, but I really hope it's a reference to Doctor Who.
They don't look like any I've ever seen.
Yeah, they look more like savage wolves and dogs. Yeah, they see me, great! Good boy! Whoa! That's one down. I'll save you for later. Are you kidding me? Now you're mine. Oh, shit!
Someone must have modified the frames. But why?
I missed the chance. I got overzealous there. Okay, worn lenses. Let's upgrade the head. Gotta admit, though, the prospect of being a mechanic and upgrading my dog, I do like. So far, I haven't found anything for upgrading my weapon, though. Hey, boy, search something. You find anything? Come on, boy, come on. God damn it. Okay, worn stabilizer in play. That could be able to fuse these together and make some new stuff. Three fusion. Cool. Perfect. Oh, shit.
April 29th, 2053.
Took
a week to reach the landing site for the supply vehicles. We had to route our crawler around a rockfall that wasn't on any of the surveys. But most of the core bots are in fine condition. And the prime core is safe, thank God. We'd never be able to terraform this planet without it. In 200 years, Far Eden will have blue skies, water, trees. It will be a paradise. Like Earth before Dust Devil. Victor will be overseeing construction of the first stage facilities while I get the prime core online. If he and the other core bots continue to perform as well as I designed them, I might not need to wake any of the other humans for this shift.
Huh. And 200 years later, I presume, and things are still shit. Shit!
Gotta do more damage.
Thank you. I thought I could sneak these guys. Like, get away with them paying attention. I look like I can, but it's tricky. Oh. Gotcha. Good boy. I'm glad I gave Mac the boost in energy. Okay, I think. Let me see here. Yes! That was obvious.
Well, well, well.
Oh, blueprint! For a head unit, excellent! Luck. Good eye for me! Alright.
The storm's getting worse! We need to get inside, quick!
Okay. Shit, he's not joking!
Once the pylons were up and running, we figured it would take about 200 years to stabilize the environment. Of course, if any of the pylons failed, all bets were off.
So, because the thing failed... Ah, shit.
The store's all powered down. Wonder if I can use that core we found to give it some juice.
Well, let's give it... Insert core.
In you go.
Come on.
Yes. In we go.
All right.
Feels good to get out of that storm, huh, boy? All right. Let's
save harbor.
Pylon controls.
Okay, so now
take a look, buddy.
I'm right where pylon 512 should be. So I'm guessing because the thing fell out of alignment that the environment went to shit. I do wonder what these crystals are for. Yeah?
Hey, another transfer plate. Just like the one in our crawler. Let's check it out.
Okay.
Huh. Looks like there's something stuck in the memory buffer.
Yeah, I tried. I couldn't use mine because of the protocol. What the heck?
Yes, of course I'm a human. My name is Jewel. What's your name?
Okay.
Violet? V10LT? Oh, you're the one locking down the transfer plates. But why? The revolution? Okay. I think Violet might be missing a few bolts, if you know what I mean.
I think he's planning the robo-apocalypse. Neo would so be all over this. Let's just proceed on. Come on, K9.
The first probes we sent to Far East found pockets of rare minerals on the surface. We all suspected we'd find a lot more underground.
Yep. It's almost like the fortress of, it's like the Fortress of Solitude in here.
Up there, the pylon controls. Come on, Mac.
Let's get some parts here and there. And look. Oh, crap. What? Nope, that's gotta be with Red, apparently.
When the Mandate discovered Far Eden, they called it a new horizon for humanity. But all I knew was that it would be the place that would take my daughter away from me. Don't get me wrong, Jewel. I was so proud watching you compete to become a member of the Far Eden team. And I knew, you leaving was partly my fault. Since you were little, it seemed all we did was talk about space. About how incredible it would be to explore other worlds. And you're so much like your mother. Brave, kind, a little reckless. Earth was too small for her. And, I guess, too small for you too. What makes me happy is that we'll be able to work together, even though we'll be far apart, to test my new invention, the Core AI. If we succeed, we won't just have built humanity a new home. We'll have revolutionized the relationship between humans and artificial life.
Oh, so her father was the one who made, like, K-9 and the other AIs possible with the cores. That's okay, that's nice. Activate the pylon.
I guess one of these cores isn't enough. We'll need more to reboot the pylon.
All right. Well, at least they opened doors. Gotta find at least three more of these mysterious cores, okay? Oh, boy.
Mac, dig in.
Find anything? Oh. Okay, no, you did not find anything. This place is rumbling a lot. Lucky!
What have we here?
Oh! Rifle Red Affinity Upgrade!
Ooh! A red ammunition amplifier.
So that's how it works.
Maybe it'll help with that door.
Let's see if it helps these guys. Okay. Oh, fuck.
A
Oh shit. Charge affinity. Okay, let's do this. Whoa, damn it, Mac! That guy isn't as durable as I thought he'd be. Well, I guess it means I can just use these red cores now. Other than the lights, there's no real visual aesthetic change. There. Red means open. Gonna call people. Oh, excuse me. Sorry.
There's the core. I just have to unlock that core socket. This pressure plate must be linked to the socket. But it's missing all of its power cells.
Damn. Oh, there's one.
A cell bot. I know where you belong, little fella. Follow me.
Come on, boy. Get in here. Alright, now to find the others. Can't break that in.
Let's see if there's anything here.
Oh, he found something! Wait, where the boy? What does he find? Thanks, boy! Don't know what it is. Oh, there we go. It's already weakened, so let me pull. Mac, mine? Thank you! Oh, in here, boy. Come on, little guy.
What? Core bikes. They ought to help me get to the other side.
So they're like basically like jump gates in a way. Okay. And look, a health pack. Hey, little guy, come on. And here we got. Oh, hind legs. Another little guy here, thank God. Okay, something is moving. You got anything here, boy? Nope. Okay, something is definitely moving underground in this place. It's creepy. Come on, boys, and here you go. Now it's just four left. I mean, just two left to go.
Mac, dig in.
Nope. I'm gonna cough. Oh god, what the hell? I just got something stuck in my throat. Anyhow, just gotta find a few more of those little battery bots. I know where they are. And there's the other guy. How the hell did I get over there? Well, in here, little guy. Come on. Get in there. Good. Now to get the other guy. There we go. I see no collectibles here, as far as I can tell. Nope. Easy peasy.
One down, two more to go.
Okay, now I level up too. Yeah, this is exactly like tug of war, essentially. More bad guy. Let's have a chance to cut the part of it. That one. Nice one, Mac. Alright, so the red augment won't do any extra damage, it'll cause a burn effect in these guys. You know, that sounds very good. Let's try over here. Let's keep going. I'll probably need more than one. And I don't think I have to go there yet. It's probably after I activate the pylon.
crossed.
Is it blue? A yellow infusion? Good boy, Mac. I got energy though. I'll take you. Good boy. Yeah, they're a good tag team actually. Nothing?
Do you hear that? There must be another one of those cores nearby.
Yeah, and a giant ass, like, rabid robot.
Let's see what we got.
I'm loving how I'm getting these blueprints so quickly. Really? I could've just...
A dead end. The core must be around here somewhere. Matt, can you find it? Go on. You can find it.
Go on, boy. Go on. Oh, it's over there, okay.
Open sesame.
Oh, shit! You'll be looking like a completely different dog. Well, it's obvious where it is. Come on, boy.
Who's a good boy? That's
an object. Prismatic core. Good boy. Sorry, man. I give you a treat, but I don't think you have a mouth or anything like that. Whoa! Bad guys. That does nothing, so let's move on. Dump bugs. Okay then, so where to now? There? Insert the core? I love how they're using the companion system and everything. And I love these robot designs. Oh, it's a RAM! Cool! But I feel like this game needs a bit more polish. Enforcer, Skull Crusher.
Last core we need is inside that thing's head.
Come on, boy, keep doing it. I really hope these boss battles don't get so repetitive. Hold still. First, Mac, see if anything here at all? There you are. Find anything? Nothing. Too bad. Let's get this pylon up and running then. Like I was saying, people, it's good concept. I like how they're trying to, like, really incorporate the whole companion system. I think it's a step in the right direction so far, but could use a bit more work. This game definitely need a bit more polish. And this is only my second Let's Play of this game. Take a look at what it looks like. I can't wait. Take another bugs. Violet?
All right. Remind me how these transfer plates work again?
They're teleportation, aren't they?
Okay. Select a transfer plate on the map to travel to its location. Find more plates to travel to more places. Got it.
I think the name is pretty self-explanatory. I mean, I can just... But I'm gonna go outside for the moment. Wanna explore. Exit a dungeon Really? The dungeon? What is this, like Dungeons and Dragons? Okay!
Look, Mac! The storm moved around a whole bunch of sand.
New areas to explore?
That's weird. I'm getting a ping from an old emergency beacon on the other side of that gate. The storm must have been blocking its signal. Come on, Mac. We better go check it out.
Wait, what are the boy? What are you? Okay. Okay!
All who wake must die.
All who wake must die? His core is all black. Okay, the sand shifts are revealing new adventures. You are now free. Explore off the main story path. Seek out dungeons with the fierce Illimni guards. Blueprints. Upgrade your core bot.
This sector is filled with rogue core bots, Mac. Before we go much further, we should head back to our crawler so I can craft you some better parts.
On that, I agree. Let's see, open. Prismatic core. And this is Lonely Basin, supply cache. Okay, before that, where? All who wake must die? I know that robot, Victor, according to subtitles, his core was all black. I'm guessing that means like total corruption or something like that.
Mac, dig in. Let's do a search.
Oh, come on, open the door.
Better be good.
All right, not bad. And let's see here, I got that the prismatic core somewhere up here. Oh, I see where it is. I get it now. Nah, damn. Yeah, I'll need the other robot for that. Let's get back for the workbench, though. Let's get them these.
Okay, Violet. Let's go.
A-okay!
I love this little guy. Wait, Tyrant's Forge? Huh. Yes. And an achievement. Let's do it, Violet. Well, the story is definitely getting a little bit more interesting with the rogue robots, obviously. I can just hear Neo calling it the robot apocalypse. It's gonna happen. I mean, and talking about Roombas and cats on Roombas and... Okay, for those of you who know what I'm talking about, yeah, you know. Alright! Well, pausing it right here, people. Thank you all for watching my Let's Play number 2 of ReCore. Well, you know what, it's only Let's Play 2, I'll just keep playing and see. As always, comment down below what you thought, and like and subscribe for more videos. Until the next time, this is Mecha-san, logging out.